وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِندَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ
تُقَالُ الْعِسَارُ الْعِظَامُ بِهِ وَيَغْدُ الْهَوَى كَكَبْشٍ ذَبِيحٍ بِذِكْرِ الْإِلَهِ.
With the mandatory charity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I mentioned in the second episode, normally joined as-salah and as-zakah together. Whenever he said, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ, and offer the prayers, establish the salah, and give the zakah. And as-zakah is a very interesting act of worship, because it does not only benefit the person who's given or doing the act of worship, rather it benefits the poor people, the needy ones. So it guarantees a welfare for the whole community. It makes people care about each other. It makes people love each other. Allah the Almighty prescribed a very small percentage on one's saving or investment to be given to the poor. We help ourselves. We help the poor from amongst ourselves. And we help ourselves because it purifies our wealth. It purifies our hearts and sanctify ourselves. Sadaqah, a charity, it's a small percentage. For instance, on one's wealth, if it is investment or saving, gold, silver or cash, trade or stocks, it's only 2.5%. Whom should we give our zakah to? The ayah goes on and on to describe 8 categories of those who are eligible for the collection of the zakah. But the general description of those 8 categories is poverty, because they are poor, they are in needy. That's why the first and the second categories were mentioned, al-fuqarâ and al-masâkîn. The poor people who can barely survive, have children to support, they cannot afford to pay the rent, they don't have any saving, any investment, and so on. And it is not a big deal, it's only 2.5%, something very little. Out of every 1,000 bucks, just give 25. No big deal. It's like you're buying a sandwich to help the poor.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.